Golok territory is located in the Amme Machin mountain range, near the source of the Mekong River. It is one of the hottest areas in Tibet. Rivers with spectacular falls course through the dense forests covering the lower part of the Golok plain. High mountain ridges protect the green pastures below. This is a land rich in natural resources. The Golopka Nomads are extraordinary horsemen. Their sturdy Nangechen horses are capable of galloping at an altitude of almost 5,000 meters above sea level. The Golopka tents dot the entire region. They make them out of yak pelts. Their black color stands out on the landscape. On both sides of the tents, we can see the flapping ryungta, or horses of the wind. These are white flags inscribed with mantras and Buddhist sutra texts. Waving in the breeze, they transport the message of Buddha through the air, a constant prayer protecting the inhabitants of this valley. They live from the bounty of the yak. The animal's manure, once dried, serves as fuel. With the animal's hides, they fashion the fabrics used for their tents. From the yak, they extract the milk products that form the base of their diet. And finally, the main source of their protein is yak meat. Their tents are quite spacious inside, though the furnishings are humble. Just what is truly indispensable, functional for their nomadic way of life. The center of their living quarters is always a hearth of clay. They usually eat twice daily, once at dawn and again at dusk, always with green tea, sometimes blended with yak butter. When they have flour, they prepare a batter they cut in small pieces and fry. They eat this with the all-important main dish, dried yak meat. The Golokpa have always been considered one of the fiercest tribes of Tibet. The French missionary Ok described them in his diary in the 19th century as a tribe of cruel warriors who, after battle, would carry out cannibalistic rituals during which they would eat the hearts of their enemies. Stories are told in more recent times of many Chinese people having been killed by these nomads who simply do not accept the presence of any foreigner in their territory. There are always two large dogs guarding the entrance to a Golokpa tent, fierce Tibetan mastiffs. They are big dogs and very strong. They have enormous heads and powerful jaws, capable of inflicting deadly scissor-like gashes. Tibetan mastiffs unleashed by the ancient Assyrians are well documented in Babylonian, Egyptian, and Greek bas-relief depictions dating back as far as 2,000 years before Christ, authentic dogs of war. The Romans spread the race around Europe and the Mediterranean, creating the Saint Bernard, the Pyrenees Mastiff, and the Great Dane.